Everybody, it's Sandy, and welcome back to my channel dedicated to helping you advocate for your own health one topic at a time. Well, as some of you already know, I had surgery for the arthritis in the joint where the thumb meets the wrist. Yeah, that's still the thumb way down there by the wrist, and that's called the CMC joint. I had an arthroplasty with tendon transfer. Now, the post-op plan in my case was about a week and a half in a splint, followed by 4 weeks in a cast for a total of 5.5 weeks of immobilization. Well, here I am at day 27. Actually, I have no cast. It's been off for several days now because something went in a way that wasn't expected. So today I want to talk about that. What happens when something goes as you've not planned? Yeah, so this kind of thing does happen. So again, I was planning to be completely immobilized for a little over 5 weeks. On day 9, I was put in a cast. You guys saw the cast in some of my earlier videos. By day 13, that cast was really causing some pain. It was somehow just knocking against, you know, this large knuckle right here on my index finger. It just became so painful that I went into my orthopedic practice and they said, yeah, it looks like maybe it could be adjusted a little bit. The fingers were a little bit, this is called ulnar deviation. And they said, let's just adjust it. We'll give you a different cast. And it was actually a more comfortable cast, and it was different in a lot of ways. So I was a little surprised. And I walked out thinking this is going to be just fine. But maybe 4, 5, 6 days later, I guess I was on day 17, I just started to feel like the burning that I had at the incision was almost unbearable against that cast. Even though they did pad it, they were so good about putting all this extra padding over that place, I was just having a lot of burning. And this knuckle that had been under the kind of pressure for those first 2 days, just because I couldn't move it around and massage it a little or get it moving, it never really did get better. So again, I called the office. I probably got the designation of that squeaky wheel, like difficult, loud patient, but I was just calling and asking if there's anything else we could do, if there's another adjustment we could make, because I was having this pain. And I was really surprised I got a call back from my surgeon's assistant saying that the surgeon wants the cast to come off and wanted me to start occupational therapy now. Of course, I was really surprised, right? Because I knew I was supposed to be immobilized like another 3+ weeks, like another 3 weeks and a few days. And I thought, if I was supposed to be immobilized all that time, like, you know, how safe is it going to be to walk around with this thing in just this like soft splint? Furthermore, what about starting occupational therapy so early? So come to find out, I knew there was a lot of variation. Surgeons handle this procedure very differently. In my area, some immobilize as short as 3 weeks and some go 5 weeks and, you know, some are somewhere in between. But it turns out that there are surgeons around the country who do this only immobilizing for a little over 2 weeks. So I was already at 2.5, right? And I was getting pretty close to 3 weeks. I actually called a friend of mine, an acquaintance that I have, who's an occupational therapist, hand specialist, and she said same thing. She said, look, they come out at all different times. It's like actually pretty arbitrary. And I think what the surgeon is thinking is that you are on the road to developing CRPS. CRPS is complex regional pain syndrome, which is something that goes on for a very long time, maybe forever. And a couple of the risk factors are being over 50, being female, and being immobilized. If whatever's hurting is immobilized, like in a cast, for example, it really raises the risk if people start developing pain of getting CRPS. So the right thing to do is to take that cast off and get into therapy and start this thing moving. So I felt a whole lot better after I had talked to her, and they took the cast off the next day. And, you know, for a few days I was in the splint and I hadn't started therapy yet. And so I was kind of holding it as though it was in a cast. So it wasn't like a whole lot better. I just kept feeling like I had to hold it really still. I did start occupational therapy. So that was like day 22. It's now day 27. I've had 3 full sessions of occupational therapy. I cannot believe the difference. Yeah, it still hurts. I'm having burning at the incision site. I think that's like nerve pain. It's also probably a little bit because my surgeon uses surgical glue instead of stitches, which is really nice in terms of the way the incision heals. But now that I see it, now that that glue is starting to flake off, I can see that it's sort of pulling a little bit. There's little tiny hairs. You know, your skin is delicate in that spot. So I am having, I think, some reaction to that glue a little bit. And that's maybe contributing to that burn sensation. But all in all, the sensation I'm having in the other joints of the hand is definitely getting better. The thumb for sure aches. I had a big surgery. There's, you know, a hole drilled in one of my bones. Another bone is missing. And, you know, this is a pretty big surgery in such a tiny little area. And, but I can tell you that I have made so much progress, and now I'm so happy that this thing went wrong. I mean, really happy, because, you know, the first day in occupational therapy, I was just supposed to start moving it, and one of the exercises I was supposed to do is try to get the thumb to touch the tips of the fingers, and I could get this one barely. It took me a while, and by, you know, 2 or 3 days later, one more session, I was able to get to the ring finger, and now I can get all the way to the pinky. Eventually, they say I'm going to slide the thumb down and touch the base of the fingers. I'm nowhere near that yet, but for 1 week, I am just so thrilled about the progress that I'm making. I can pick up little pegs. I'm supposed to put them in, you know, holes and take them out and put them back down. I'm doing other exercises like what they call nerve flossing and all kinds of things. So I really thought about at the end of this week what I've learned here. I realize I've learned this lesson again and again and again over my lifetime, and I guess it's taken me like 50 something years to find the common denominator, which is that sometimes when things don't go the way you're planning, it's actually better. Let it be and let it unfurl. Try to trust in the people around you who are there to help you, like in this case, my surgeon, my occupational therapist, or try to trust in just fate if that's what it is, because this might not be a medical thing that doesn't go the way you want or the way you've planned. Try to accept it, because very often it turns out that it's for the better. So I've learned that yet one more time, and I don't know, will I have the forethought to see that happening when this something like this is unfurling the next time? I don't know, that's what I'm hoping for, because like I said, it's taken me a really long time. I've always been really type A and didn't tend to, I guess, trust it enough to leave things in the hands of either other people or fate a little bit, whatever it might be. And one of the lessons here is not only that sometimes it works out better, but however it works out, I'm going to have the capacity to deal with that as well. Being able to just trust in my own ability that I can cope with whatever lies ahead, however this unfurls, whether it's the way I've planned or not, you know, that can serve to be very calming. And I wish I'd learned this earlier. You know, they say youth is wasted on the young. It would have been very helpful if I'd had this like throughout my years of raising children. If having this happen is one of the things it took to help just reinforce this and help me recognize it and maybe use it the next time, I'm grateful for that too. Of course, the $25,000 question is going to be, how do I do in the end, in the final end, like several months from now when we get a look at what is my final outcome? Well, that's true for everybody. I think that's true whether you've had a cast on for 5 weeks or 2 weeks, or, you know, there's probably so many variables that go into that, including just your individual, your body's ability to heal and how well you do the exercises, how well you can do with things, and all sorts of things go into that. But I'm very hopeful at this point that I have an excellent chance of a good outcome. The only thing I see that, you know, maybe would have been a little better in terms of leaving that cast on for me is I can see that I've sort of put a little strain on that incision. Now, there's a good side to that too, because scar tissue, once it builds up, one of the things you have to do when you go to occupational therapy, if you've been immobilized for like 5 weeks, one of the things the therapist has to do is to help you to break down all that scar tissue, because, you know, hold your hand in one position for 5 weeks and see how it feels. It'll be very, very stiff. And some of that is the way everything is healed with scar tissue. It heals very still like that. And one of the things you really have to do is break all that down. On the good side, I'm not having to do all that because it didn't have a chance to build quite that strongly, that scar tissue. But I do see I'm putting a little strain on the incision. Maybe I'm going to end up with a tiny bit like of a wider scar. I don't know. I'm totally speculating. But, you know, honestly, I would do that 100,000 times over to just be able to have gotten this mobility back so soon. So, you know, I am wondering what happens when it's time to do the other side. My other side is already a candidate for that surgery, but I'm really hoping to get a lot of time, not have to do it anytime soon, just because the post-op course is several months. And even at that, they say it takes a good 6 months in the best of circumstances until you build back all your strength. So like doing yoga, for example, I put some weight on my hands and wrists. I'm wondering when I'm going to be able to do that. That will probably be months. I'm hoping I get some good quality lifetime in between doing the two procedures. But when it does come time to do the other hand, which is my dominant hand, my right, one of the things I'm going to discuss is whether it can be done the same exact way, or whether they're going to want to try all over again for a plan A being 5 weeks of immobilization. And I don't know if they tell me that it's going to be the latter. I wonder if I might go elsewhere and see what other people are doing at that time. Now being in the midst of doing it this way, I'm so glad it happened. So I don't know, anybody who's had this surgery before, let me know what your experience was, short or long period of immobilization and how it worked out. And more broadly, if you've had anything else that didn't go according to plan A, we all have that experience, right? If you have a chance to look back and ask yourself, how many times, if you had it to do again, would you take it back? If you could go back and it was going to work out like with plan A, how many times in your life that didn't happen, would you take that opportunity to go back? I can honestly say almost zero for me. Most of the time when something doesn't go for me according to the plan I had, it ends up unfurling into other things. And even though I was unhappy with that result or that outcome, either I gained a new skill from it or I gained some new strength because I had to cope with a situation that I otherwise wouldn't have, had to exercise that muscle, or sometimes something really good happened that I wasn't expecting, and then that wouldn't have happened if I could do it all again and have it the way I had originally wanted. So, this is a good life lesson. In my case, I'm so glad it's, working out the way it is. Anyway, let me know if you've had anything similar and what you've learned from it and what you might recommend. And until next time, be well. Bye-bye.